All right, welcome to the very last little section in photo restoration, which is Instagram effects. So we're going to be applying a lot of the same options and tools and techniques that we did with photo restoration, but we're going to use them in a more artistic manner. We're not going to be trying to make them look realistic. We're going to be trying to make them look more artistic. So the first thing we're going to do is I'm going to show you how to make an image black and white. Today we're going to go into the digital image archive for the first time. You can do this with any of the pictures that you brought in, your own personal photos, or you can go to My Image Archive. So if you're going to be using My Photos, you're going to go to Courses, Art, and we're going to go to Digital Image Archive, and you can open up any of these photos. I'm going to go into People, I'm going to go to Extra Large so I can see what I've got here, and you do need to pick a color photo. Oh, let's go with my adorable niece. So let's open up file. Again, you can open up any color photo you want to. We're going to learn several different techniques and options in this lesson. There's a couple different ways that you can make an image black and white. The first and the easiest is to simply go to Image Adjustments and go to Desaturate. Bam, it removes all the color. That's the easiest way to do it. The other way you can do it is to go to Image Adjustments, Hue and Saturation, and you can take the saturation all the way down here. The nice thing about doing it this way is you can make it completely black and white, or you can make it have a subtle color, so it's a really muted tone. So that's another option that you have. But let's go ahead and completely desaturate it and click OK. We're not completely done. The last thing you want to do is you want to fix your tones. So I'm going to go into my levels, because you'll find for a lot of images, once you remove the color, it also then lacks contrast. So you want to just make sure you're using your levels to make that a nice, good before and after. So this is before, you can see it's kind of washed out, and this is after. You might even decide that you need to selectively, just like with those dodge tools, I'm increasing the shadow there because I feel like I can't see her hand. Do you see how it's kind of blending in? So what I'm doing is I'm taking that dodge tool. I'm increasing where the shadows are, so it gives it a little bit more contrast here in her clothing. Maybe across her eyes, bring her eyes out a little bit more. So that's where those selective tools really help. Alright, so once you've done that with a black and white photo, I want you to save this. I'm going to go to File, Save As. You're going to save this in your Lessons folder. And I want you to call it Black and White. And click Save. We're going to quickly move on. We're going to go rapid fast today. So that's turning out an image black and white. Open up another color image. So go ahead and take a minute. Open up any image you wish. For this next technique, I'm going to show you how to create a spot color. It's really easy to do. It's pretty fun. It's an easy technique. First, start by desaturating your image. And then it just requires a simple tool. It's going to require your history brush tool, which is in this drawer here. Works just like any other brush. Make it the size you want. And you're simply going to brush across what you want to bring back in color. All it's doing is it's going back in a previous history state. So in other words, it's going back one step, but just in one area rather than the whole thing. So you can do it just in one area or a small area, but that's your spot color. Kind of a cool thing you can do with this too. Let me show you. I can take the opacity down, so it's not making it... Because it sometimes seems like it's super duper bright. when you're at full strength. So it kind of gives you that muted. All right, so go ahead and have some fun with that. When you come up with a good spot color, just go to File, Save As. Save it in your Lessons folder as Spot Color. Moving on. Again, open up any color image. All right, in this one, I'm going to show you how to create a purposeful color cast. I'm going to start by desaturating. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fix my tones. So in other words, I'm going to go through those same steps I do for a black and white image. You know, I'm going to make it look good. I'm going to selectively increase highlights or shadow. And then here's how you create a color cast, or what's called a duotone. Sometimes it's called sepia tone. You go to Image Adjustments, and we're going to go to Hue and Saturation. You have to hit Colorize, and then you can go ahead and change your colors here. So you're actually giving a color cast to your image. So if you have, like, instead of black and white, you want what's called a sepia tone, so it kind of looks old-timey, like if you go to Wisconsin Dells and then you put on those stupid costumes. This is what they're doing. They're making it a black and white, and then they're just doing a duotone, which is with a brownish color to it. So go ahead and play with that, or you can be fun and crazy. You can make it a blue or green cast, whatever you want to do. Click OK. File, Save As. And we're going to call this one Duo Tone. Duo meaning two, it's a two-toned image. And you'll click OK. Going this pretty fast. Alright, go ahead and close that one out. Go ahead and open up yet another color image. I'm probably just going to open up a few just for the next few ones that we're using here. Alrighty. So for this one, I'm just going to show you how to do what's called a vignette. So you can do vignettes a couple different ways, and I'm going to show you vignettes with some other options. So what a vignette simply means is you have an area that's protected and used to highlight. So it's a focal point. You have to start by using selections to do that. We're going to use two selection tools. You're either going to use the elliptical marquee tool or the rectangular marquee tool. Let's go ahead and switch to the rectangular marquee tool. I'm going to show you what you can do, and I'm going to make some changes to this. So if I wanted to highlight, this is my son here. If I wanted to highlight him, I would click and drag around him. Now, if I made changes, it would make the changes to him and leave everything else raw or unchanged. But with this, you want to inverse it. So you're going to select inverse. And then what you do to this area here is up to you, but you're going to use an image adjustment command to somehow make this look different. So you would go to maybe image adjustments. You could go to brightness and contrast and take the brightness down. You could go to image adjustments. You could take the saturation down and make it kind of black and white. You could go to image adjustments, color balance, and change it anything so that this looks different than this area here. You could even add that surface blur or something called a Gaussian blur. So, pass the salad and stop and smell the rosemary. It's easy when you fill your cart with which is the typical vignette. Most vignettes, they're using a blur filter, or they'll use a blur filter and maybe a darkening filter or a darkening adjustment. Now let's look what that looks like. Here's a problem with doing it this way. Do you see this hard edge here? I'm going to show you how to fix that for this vignette. Let's open up our history panel. We're going to go back to the beginning. Before I drag my selection, up here in my options bar, I'm going to take my feather and I'm going to add a feather. Now, it really depends on whatever your resolution for your image is. If this is a high resolution image, you're going to want a feather that's probably around 50 pixels or higher. If it's a very low res picture, you might take it down to 10. What feathering does is it means that the edge is softened. It's not a crisp edge as if you took a pair of scissors. So if I release my mouse button, you're going to see it actually even rounds off the edges a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and take that brightness down. Oops, I forgot to do one important thing. What did I forget to do? I forgot to inverse it. Take that brightness down, making everything around him dark. Now, if I deselect that, you can see how it doesn't cut right away. It gradually goes. Now, I can make it even more subtle. I would just have to go back and undo that. I would have to take the feather, so that's why I said you might need to go above 50. I'm going to go all the way up to 100 pixels. I'm going to drag that selection around him. I'm going to inverse it. Take my brightness down. Now if I deselect, it's hard to tell where that selection border is. See, I've now created what's called a vignette. Right, I'm going to reselect that. I'm going to put a slight blur on it so you can see. A good Gaussian blur. Gaussian blur is always a really good one for your vignettes. And I'm deselecting. So now you can see what we've done is we've put the focus on him. I'm going to quickly show you one other way to do that. I'm going to do it with this image here. I'm going to switch to my elliptical marquee. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put a feather on it again. I'm going to stick with that 100. Just because I want to show you what the elliptical will look like. And I'm going to take the hue and saturation down. I want to show you something here. If you look here, see how on his hand, how it gradually desaturates. Oops. It gradually desaturates. And I'm going to reselect it. I'm going to make it darker too. But again, you can use any image adjustment command you want here. And you can combine them. The idea of a vignette is you're just using one of those marquees. It helps focus your eye. You're just doing something slightly more creative. Right? So either using the rectangle or the elliptical, go ahead and make a vignette. And then I want you to go to File, Save As. I want you to save it in your Lessons folder. And I want you to call it Vignette. Vignette is V-I-G-N-E-T-T-E. And click Save. We have one last technique we're going to learn. And that's something called a photo filter. Okay. What a photo filter does is there tend to be warming or cooling filters, which just soften the feel of the image. They are in image adjustments. If you go under image adjustments, you'll see where it says photo filter. And there are some options here. You've got warming ones, which these are your more basic ones. If you go into Instagram, this is exactly what they're using. They're using different warming filters that have some variations on them. So you can just see it's changing the colors, either making it warmer or cooler. And depending on these top three, this warming filter uses an orange to warm it. This one uses, and you can even change the color. You can use it more of a red. It's tinting it. It's almost like using color cast, but it's using a little bit more of a predetermined idea of what warming and cooling looks like. So you can go ahead and use that. You can even apply it a couple different times. Show you what the cooling filters look like. It's going to make it look like it's underwater. I will be honest, most of the time you're going to use one of the three warming ones rather than the cooling. You can use any of these. There is a sepia one. I showed you how to do it manually. There is a sepia tone, which will, instead of making it completely desaturated black and white, and then the sepia tone over top, you can use this. So go ahead and play with these photo filter options when you come up with a finished piece that you like. I want you to go to File, Save As. Save it in your Lessons folder. And I want you to call it Photo Filter. And you are done with the last lesson on Instagram effects or Instagram filters. Congratulations.